guys, welcome to Smoo's Workshop, and apologies for the lack of updates of late. Yes, I know, we're into May. Try not to destroy your models, Terry. And I've not really put anything for January, February, March, April. March and April were sort of didn't do anything months. May, I seem to have got a bit of a mojo back, which is a good thing. Lack of updates are mainly due to some things that were going on that some of you might have noticed, but I don't want to go into any detail on. So I've decided my mojo back and I'm going to get on with some model building. Yay! I've also noticed just recently I'm up to 97 subscribers. 97 people daft enough to watch videos about me trying to make models in my sort of novice capability after 30 years away from the craft. So thanks again for all the subscribers. Right, main project that I had ongoing was my Russian T-55. Just tweak the camera down here. My little tank, which I didn't manage to get finished in time for the International Skill Modellers Forum group build from Russia with Love. And I really do, it's literally just a little bit of matte varnish here and there, which I'll be doing with this stuff. It's really good stuff. And a little bit of highlighting with Tamiya's now. Let me see if I can find it. X20. Where's it hiding? Yep, standard X22 clear. That I'll be using to highlight some of the fuel spills, etc. This is a complete model. It is completed, apart from a little bit of a matte varnishing, and as I say, some highlighting of fuel spills and things like that. I didn't get finishing time for International Skill Modellers Forum for various reasons, and I will be completing it, but my mojo isn't with armour builds. I've got a couple going in the background, but armour's not my thing. So those that have been following me know that bikes are my thing. So I'll go on to the next one. Right. This one. My Yamaha RZ250 or Yamaha RD250LC for people in the UK build. You've seen where I've got to. I've been doing a build, get my teeth in, a build video series on how I've got to this stage so far and the problems I've had trying to get rid of seam lines, etc. And I was going to go on to spraying with cellulose paints rather than acrylics. I will get into that, and there's my little carpet monster protection pot. Oh god, Terry, get your teeth in. Anyway, CMPP. Bike's looking lovely for me. I do think there's a couple of things I could possibly retouch on the chrome forks, but I'll go into that later. I'm going to be experimenting with some new metallic paints. So this month I will get on with this build. You will see me spraying these body parts. I'm going to be doing it with the Tamiya colour, pure white. Now, I'm not going to be using this rattle can. I'm going to be decanting it and using it with my airbrush, my new airbrush. So I'm trying to plan the next build video on this, where I spray all these parts and get them up to a decent standard of finish. Are you interested in seeing why I have went with the Tamiya colour paints rather than these new Zero paints? Well, I'll be quite honest, when I first came back into modelling, I knew nothing about Zero paints, and I bought all the Tamiya paints over a period of time, because they're quite expensive, so that I could spray my models. And I found that there was a lot of paint wastage with the tins through overspray, and the fact that a spray can sprays quite heavily, and that I've experimented with decanting and finding I'm getting a more economical use per tin for the colour that I want with the models. So if you want me to include how I decant them and how I actually go about spraying the next section of the build, please comment and say that's interesting to you. Otherwise, I'll just skip by it when I do my next build video. So yeah, so that's kind of the two main builds that I had going. And I've got my new man space set up, as you can see. I'm back in my flat. And yep, that's all my racks and stuff, and that's my little spray booth in the corner. So, right, what am I planning next? I've got my mojo back, but my mojo is bikes. Right, now, I've been following a guy called Tony from Helgen's 35 workshop, if you've watched any of his build videos. And he did a fantastic build for E-models on, let's see if I can get this, there we go, Yamaha YZR M109. Beautiful bike, absolutely fantastic. Valentino rode this during the time, and as I say, Tony has already done a cracking build video on this. But it had been one that I've got in my stash. I didn't pay the book price from it. I think I paid about £24 off of eBay for this kit. They go from like 35 to 45 quid, which is crazy. And I've been thinking about doing this as long as along with a dual build of the same bike but in a different livery. And I've thought to myself, why wait until I've got enough money to buy all the parts that I want to do with the other bike and just get cracking with this? So Tony, your fault, I'm actually going to do a build on this and I'm going to video it. Now, it might not be the way that everybody builds bikes, but it's going to be my way of building it, and with my limited experience since I've come back to the modelling sort of fraternity as it was, how I'm going to approach it. So yeah, Tony, I'm going to do a step-by-step build on this as well. Probably won't be as good or as detailed as yours, but I'm going to have a go. So that's what's planned. Now, for all I have said to certain people, for which I apologise, that they're all about detail-up kits and spending loads of money on a kit and all the rest of it, I'd love to do that. But I have managed, for this kit, to get at least the front forks detail up kit for this bike. So I mean, these go from anything from, if you look on eBay, anything from £13 up to £26 if you buy in the UK and pay full retail. I got these from Japan, and I've got two of these. Yes, I do like detail up kits. I generally can't afford them. But these are kits that I've had for a while and I've been saving up, and I managed to get two of the fork detail up kits because I also have another friend of mine has got this as well, and I'm pretty sure Tony has as well. Now, this is the same bike, this is the Yamaha YZR M109, but it's a Fiat Yamaha Team Estoril Edition. Obviously, when they raced at different tracks, the team had enough money to spend on different livery and all the rest of it. Now, my plan has always been with this bike, apart from the front fork detail upset, and I don't normally have the money to buy photo etch kits or any other detail up kits, but I've always been wanting to do this bike with a full carbon effect, with a front fork detail up kit, which I have got. But I also want to do a photo etch kit in it from Top Studio, which, although at £27, doesn't seem a lot of money, has taken me a while to save up for. And I also want to do the photo etch detail up kit of the chain, which is another 30 quid. I've almost got the money together to get these detail up kits. So although I was going to do the two bikes as a dual build, I'm still saving up for the photo etch and detail up kit for this one. But I am going to go ahead with, excuse me a second, this one, which is the one that Tony did, and it's available from E-Models. Now, Although I'm going to be using the front fork detail upset kit for this one, I have had for ages and I'm halfway through the build of this kit, which is the Valentino Rossi riding figure, which goes on the same said bike. Now, before I even knew about Tony and his Helgen 35's workshop, I had started on my character with all the various decals, etc. And I got kind of stumped when I got to the helmet stage and the decals, and I noticed when reviewing his video on how to do it that I got the first main decal, and now I look at it upside down. There you go. Didn't pay attention to instructions. So this has kind of been sitting on the back burner for a while, and I seen Tony's video and going, I really need to get on with this. And I've had the YZR M109 in my stash for 6 months and I haven't done anything with it. Now, this brings me on to the paint I'll be using with it. Tony used the standard Tamiya paints on his. The paints that Tamiya recommend are TS26 Pure White and TS51 Racing Blue. I might have got that slightly wrong, but I do have the right blue in my stash. They are cellulose based paints, but they're in a rattle can. Now, until I got my airbrush, I was doing all my models with rattle cans, which is why I bought a load of rattle cans to do the models that I have in my stash. And then I found out about zero paints, etc, etc. So my move to zero paints and possibly a product review will be at a later date. But these are the paints I'm going to use on that model. But trying to get them from a rattle can into a pot and then into an airbrush is something that maybe people haven't tried. These work out cheaper than zero paints. And they also don't have a matte finish. They have a gloss finish. And because they're cellulose based, they're perfectly fine for putting decals on. So if you guys are interested on seeing how I decant the paint, and my efforts in trying to put these paints down then with an airbrush on the actual model itself, let me know in the comments. That's the plans with that. So I've got definitely going to get on with my RZ250 build, and I want to go away from armour and back onto bikes, which is my love. So the YZR M109, I'm going to be doing that. Now, another big problem I've come across is, so far I've reviewed, you'll notice I've reviewed a few kits, but they're what I'm aiming at is I'm trying to get the back catalogue of the Tamiya bike kits in the 1/12 scale. So a lot of them, the early chrome in that is, although it's not actually chrome, it's aluminium, it's put onto the plastic using a vacuumised method. But anyway, trying to replicate chrome, because when you get a seam and two parts are together, you get the seam line down the middle of an exhaust, which you don't get in a real bike. And I would like to try out some paints to see if we're never going to get the exact chrome finish that you get on especially later Tamiya kits, that you will with a paint. But I'm trying to see what I can get to be as near as. So once the pennies allow, I'm going to order in some AK Interactive Extreme Metals buffable paints to try. I'm going to try some of a company called Mr. Hobby, a Japanese company. They also make paints, and they've got an extreme metal range out just now, and I want to try those. Now, luckily enough, I've got lots of old bits of bikes sitting about. I mean, there's an exhaust there sitting off a kit that I didn't need to use. So I'm going to practice on that with some of these new metallic paints and see what effect they give when they're buffed up. Are they chrome-like? And I might actually do a heat staining video where I will take images of real bikes and see whether we can recreate the red, blue, yellow, smoky sort of colour of the heat staining on the bikes. It's all new to me. I've never tried it before, so I've got some parts that I can try that with. Right, okay. One of the main reasons of me getting my mojo back up is I've got a lot of followers. Well, I've not got a lot of followers, but a few followers that are doing bike builds, which are dear to my heart, and they're posting up all these lovely pictures of their builds, and I'm like, I've got to get into that. Oh, he's doing that better than me. My biggest bugbear is decals. And when I first started off modelling, I used a stuff. Have I got it handy? Yes, I have got it handy. I didn't know about Microset and Microsol. I went in my modelling shop and I seen this stuff and I thought, because when I used to do modelling, you're talking Airfix models, you know, Spitfires and that. You put a decal on and you'd. Anyway, this stuff's shit. Yep, that's my review of Humbrol Decalfix. It's shit. Sorry, Humbrol Decalfix, but it's shit. But it's really good at stripping paint off your brushes. So if you want to use it as a brush cleaner for acrylic paints, then get yourself some Humbrol Decalfix. Otherwise, fling it in the bin. So yeah, decals. There's a lot of nice MotoGP bikes out there that I would love to build, but they're highly decal intensive. So I've tended to stick to basic bikes with basic decals on, like tank logo, maybe a side casing logo, stuff like that. And I've encountered big problems, probably due to using Decalfix, with MotoGP bikes that are highly decal intensive. So this is an idea. Just tell me if you're interested in it. But I have a bike kit that I bought from eBay. This one, I'll just thing right there. Beautiful bike. Kit came with absolutely no engine parts. So I have a bike kit. And by the way, if anybody is interested in a decal set for this bike, which has the Rothmans graphics on it, give me a shout because it is specific to this bike, which is the Honda NSR 500. I have no use for them. They are sealed and in the bag, and they're made by a company called MSM Creations. If you've got that bike and you're looking for that decal set, I've got them. And I won't be using them. And I probably also won't be using the standard graphics that come with it as well. And I don't think they're Cartograph. They're pretty much standard Tamiya as well. So I've been left with a lot of parts. The kit itself comes with a clear fairing. Things like brake discs and exhausts, body panels. Also comes with fairings that are a standard white plastic, spare set of tyres and all that. I'm going to use this as my test mule. It doesn't have an engine, so I'm thinking to myself, I'm looking at aftermarket carbon fibre decals and things like that. I'm thinking of, now I'm not very good at it, doing a video that shows applying decals to, rather than your standard, you know, flat surface stuff, things like, where have we got them? I'm just looking for it in here. Awkward mudguard shapes and awkward fairings and things like that. But I'll do it with aftermarket decals. Possibly even the crappy, to think of a better word, Tamiya decals in the kit. And I'm also want to do some testing on some new metallic paints from AK and Mr. Hobby Extreme Metallics. And I thought, what better to try it on than actual model parts? So I could do maybe this exhaust in the AKA Extreme Buffables, and this one in the Mr. Hobby Extreme Metals, to see what's the best chrome and things like that. That's ideas that's toying about in my head. I've got a model to try it with. As I say, I have decals there that I'm not going to use, and this is basically a scrap bike. So that's that. So when I started my model building, I didn't know about zero paint, so I'm going to be using the tins. I'll show you how to decant them if you're interested. And that's it. There's no real anywhere to go from that. I haven't done anything for literally 3 months. You've maybe been following my T55 build and it's came to a standstill. I will get it finished and there will be a reveal. It's an amateur look at building an armour model using various techniques of weathering, and got it to the stage I've got, which is nowhere by any means perfect, but it's kind of like that's where I've got with that. But the bikes, I'm going to be concentrating more on detail finish, and I think every bike I'm going to build, I'm going to do a video build of it. Not so much to tell you how to suck eggs and how to do it, but just sort of to show you what I do, and if you can get better than me, which is quite easy, go from there. So yeah, that's it. So a big thank you to my 97 subscribers. This is Terry from Smoo's Workshop, and yeah, more bike builds for me. I'm definitely going to be doing, I've got a ton of inbox reviews of my stash that I haven't done. As I say, I mostly buy the retro kits, which might not interest all, but I'm doing it in numerical sequence, so I'll be getting into the newer kits. And obviously, if I'm doing the Yamaha YZRM109, I will do a review of the kit. Even though it's a two different boxes, it's the same kit with different decals. I'll get those done. So yeah, if you guys want to see anything, or would like clarification on anything, or how to do something, if I know how to do it, then I can incorporate this into future video builds. If I don't know how to do it, you're learning along with me. So for now, Terry from Smoo's Workshop. Thanks for listening to my waffle, and hopefully some more bike builds. See you later. Bye.